India, home to some of the most iconic and endangered animals on the planet. Creatures like the Bengal tiger and the Asian elephant all share this subcontinent with over a billion people. What most people don't know is there's an animal normally only associated with Africa living in a remote part of this country. This part of India is domain to the king of the jungle, the last surviving Asian lion. My name's Adam Thorn. I'm an animal expert, adventurer, and explorer. I journey into some of the most treacherous and formidable environments known to man, in search of the most rare, dangerous, and downright bizarre creatures this planet has to offer. I'm in Sasangir, a small town mostly consisting of farms and mango plantations. What makes this town so unusual is that it is nestled smack bang in the middle of lion territory. The Gir Forest is the sole home for the last population of Asiatic lion. This lion subspecies once spread throughout southeastern Europe, the Middle East, and much of India. However, due to hunting and habitat loss, there are only about 500 left. In the past few years, reports of these lions leaving the forest and establishing populations hundreds of kilometers away from their natural home are becoming more and more common. My mission is to find out why. My first point of business is to talk to the locals. These people live close to these animals, and if I have any chance of seeing these cats, I need to get as much information as possible.
We just want to see lions, that's all.
The locals tell me I've come in the wrong time of the year. Because I've come during the winter, there is plenty of water in the forest. This means the lions will be scattered throughout the area, unlike during the dry summer, where they are never too far from a permanent waterhole. This information hasn't deterred me, so I've decided to get out there and explore the lion's habitat. This will help me better understand which animals are in the area and if there's any evidence of big cats.
Walking game trails and paths is a pretty handy tool. It allows you to see which animals are in the area and also which way they're heading.
If I can study the biodiversity of this area and find potential food sources for these lions, it may give me a clearer picture of why these lions are leaving this forest and establishing new territories.
There.
It seems lions aren't the only big cat that haunt this forest.
Those are feathers from a female peacock, a peahen. Now something's had a go at that, and I think I know what it could be. There might be a leopard in the area. So, gotta be pretty cautious, because a peahen doesn't fill up a leopard.
Following the game trail a little further, I found more evidence that the leopard was close by.
This is leopard poop. Leopard tutty, and it's just full of fur. Now fur can be a good thing in big cats because it's kind of like fiber in humans. It sort of scrubs them out, scrubs parasites out of them, cleans out their pipes. Definitely large predators in the area, and this game trail seems to be a pretty popular route for these cats. Amazing.
Spending only a small amount of time in this forest, it was clear that this habitat was abundant with animals. Anything from small lizards, birds, and insects, to large quadrupeds. Sambar, a large deer which can weigh over 500 kilograms. They are a common food source for tigers in central India, but are also on the menu for lions. Native animals aren't the only thing on the menu in this forest. And to the lions, domesticated animals are an even easier meal.
This is the jawbone of a young cow or buffalo. Now it's an old bone, so whatever killed it probably isn't in the area, but I would say this is a very old lion kill. Now at one point, cattle made up about 60% of the Asiatic lion's diet. I was stealing from farmers and cattle herders. Thankfully, the population of chital deer have exploded, over 50,000. So the lions now prefer to hunt their natural food source instead of the cattle. Good for the farmers and the cows, not good for the chital.
Chital, or white-spotted deer, are the most common hoofed animal in this region. Over the last decade, their numbers have exploded, and they are now the staple food source in the Asiatic lion's diet. Previous to this, cattle and other livestock made up the majority of the lion's food. It was such a problem that the Gujarati government had to start reimbursing the farmers for lost cattle to stop them poisoning the lions. The cattle herders of the Gir forest are called the Maldari. They are a nomadic tribe and the only people allowed to live in this forest. The Maldari have been living like this for nearly 700 years and once supplied milk and cheese to the palaces of Rajas. Asiatic lions are only slightly smaller than their African cousins, but they are just as formidable. These cats can weigh nearly 200 kilograms and are known man-eaters. Like the Maldari, I'm carrying a stick as my only defense against lions. If we see a lion and he's close to us, best thing to do is to stand your ground. If you run, he'll be on you in 2 seconds flat. That's how they see their prey. Prey runs from them. So straight in their heads, prey. So hold your ground. That's why I've got this stick. And hopefully it doesn't come to that, because I have no intentions of fighting a lion. It's a fight that I will not win.
Searching game trails is definitely paying off, and I'm finding more telltale signs that lions are in the area.
This is Samba deer fur, and also lion scat. Yeah. That is lion poo. It still smells pretty bad, so it's quite fresh. Maybe a few days, even a week. And there's little bits of claw in there as well. Whew! And it stinks. So there's definitely a lion in the area. There's probably a few lions in the area. I'm just going to try to look out for some pud marks, but it is quite old, so the marks have probably worn off by now. But there's a fresher bit of scat just over there with more Samba deer fur in it.
All right, this one is the even fresher one. You can see it's still got some moisture to it and still got that smell. But what is interesting is you can even see little bits of bone. This might even be a bit of antler as well. And if I was to pick through this, which I'm probably not going to, I'll find maybe bits of hoof, teeth even. Lions' digestive systems are really good at breaking down bone and flesh. So what's left isn't much, but still telltale signs of what animal it is. Oh, and it does smell. What is that?
Once I find a lion here in the protected area, I can expand my search to outside this forest and see just how far away from their natural habitat these lions are roaming. I just need to find one first.
Now, we've been tracking lions for about an hour and a half now, looking for paw prints and stuff on the road, but no luck yet. It is starting to warm up, so the lions become a little bit less active than they are in the morning. So hopefully we get lucky and can find ourselves a lion.
Every animal I find is another clue into better understanding this forest and the health of its ecosystem. Finding the animals lower on the food chain will help me find the animal at the top.
Got him. This is a dragon lizard, the Indian dragon lizard. Now, they're part of the agamid family. So same family as bearded dragons, frilled-neck lizards. He'll be eating insects, but also flowers and fruits. They are semi-arboreal animals as well, so which means they live in trees. And they spend a lot of their time up small shrubs. Even shrubs this size is enough to keep him hidden. Ah, he just bit me and he bit me again. Oh, he's got some teeth on him. Now look at the spikes down his back. This is a protection thing and also a camouflage thing. Makes them look textured with their surroundings. He does have a dewlap, flap of skin under his neck, which he uses to flag for females but also fend off rival animals like other males. Look at the colours on him. He's almost a coppery yellow, orangey in colour. I love these little guys. Often they're mistaken for chameleons, which is understandable, but they're not even from the same family. Ah! Sorry, why'd I put my finger right in front of you? Beautiful lizard. We'll let him go.
It's starting to get dark over the Gir Forest, so it's time to call it a day and head back to civilization. I've found lion scat and a lion kill, but still no cats. The next morning, I'm up bright and early. I've decided to check the riverbanks close to the town. There's a lot of mud surrounding the water, so if any lions come here to drink, their paw prints will be well preserved.
This is the Hiran River, and it runs all the way through the villages and up into the Gir Forest. Now, I've seen quite a few mugger crocodiles on the banks here. Saw one less than about 30 metres from some little kids swimming in the river. But this water source is very valuable for ungulates, leopards, and also lions. So I'm going to follow this river up into the forest and see if I can find any of those animals.
Not far up the river, my lion search was put on hold. Some of the local kids insisted on showing me a crocodile and also wanted me to catch it. Naturally, I said yes.
Big mugger mug? Yeah?
Yeah, big one. Yet they're still walking through the river.
These kids have grown up with the local wildlife, so this was a good chance to get to know them and pick their brains about the animals that they encounter.
Someone to eat. Yeah, come show. Yeah, I caught the crabs in India as well just before. How did he get that job? Alright, do you want to show me?
Yeah.
There's no crocodiles under that rock. I think they were lying to me. There's no crocs under rocks. Croc rock.
Mugger crocodiles can grow to 5 metres in length and have been known to eat people. But I have a feeling the crocodile these kids are going to show me is much smaller.
Yeah, lots of lizards, branches. Yep, just done that. We're going to go see the mugger crocodile. They've just seen it. It was the same one we tried to get before. He's come back out. And word's gotten around that I'm looking for the animals around the place, and so the local boys have come up and told me about it. He's ages away. Yeah. Go around. I agree. Crocodiles are pretty cool.
Snake.
It's the fastest snake I've ever seen in my life.
Where'd it go?
It's got long gone. He's looking right at me. Crocodiles have really good eyesight, so he's probably already seen me. He's been basking all day in the sun, so he's full of energy.
Whoa, sick. I knew I wasn't going to catch this crocodile. I'd tried to catch this same one the day before, so he was onto me and could see me coming a mile away. It also doesn't help having about 50 people cheering and screaming at me from the bridge. However, this was a good opportunity to ask these kids about the lions.
You see lion? Sawaj?
Yes, Sawaj.
Sawaj, in right here?
Yes.
Close?
Raat mein aate hai, Raj. Raat ko hote hai na, tab aate hai. Night.
At night time?
Yes. Yeah.
Yeah.
Really? That's so
close. Night time, your drink.
They drink from this river.
Abhi aise do.
Two.
Two lions.
When?
Yes.
When?
Abhi wahan hum khade the na upar.
How long ago?
Upar. Wahan. Wahan.
Pool.
Wahan hum yahan.
Pool. Ah, right.
Wo wahan the. Aur hum wahan.
Okay.
Yes.
That's so close to home. So close to house.
Yeah.
Very close to people.
इसको समझ नहीं आ रहा
है। Yeah.
मुझको कोई समझ नहीं आ रहा।
देखो वहाँ मच्छी।
Okay.
Dolphin. वहाँ।
Dolphin.
Dolphin.
There's no dolphin in here.
Fish.
Yeah.
Fish. Dolphin. No, you're way the
worst. You off? See you later, buddy. Worst handshake ever. See you, buddy. Yeah, alright, another one. Yeah, that'll do. That'll be a secret handshake. See you, boys.
Bye-bye.
After that short digression, it's back to searching for lions. It is very easy to become distracted in this amazing forest.
I mean, considering how polluted India is and how many people are living here, life is actually flourishing. There's so much fish in this river. There's frogs jumping into the water. Frogs indicate a healthy ecosystem. They have very porous skin and they absorb so much of the oxygen through their skin. And if that oxygen is polluted, then there won't be any frogs. So frogs are definitely a good barometer for the environment. Watch where you put your hands, there's spikes in nearly every single tree.
Most of the villagers that live on the outskirts of this forest are reluctant to come here, in fear of lion attack. This is why there is basically no pollution here, and another reason why there is so much wildlife.
So I've been sitting here watching this troop of langur monkeys for about half hour. They're all running past, and they're starting to do their distress call. So I don't know if that distress call is because I'm here or something else. Langur monkeys, or Hanuman langurs, are the biggest primates in the whole of India. But although they're so big for a monkey, they're also so agile in the trees. And even on the floor, you see them running through the forest and they do this gallop and stuff. It's pretty amazing.
Monitor lizards also call this forest home, and I never pass up the opportunity to try and catch one.
Look at his tail. Put up one bit of a fight there, buddy. Indian rock monitor. Hello. And he's a fairly decent sized one as well, jeez. They wedge themselves into tight crevices and then puff their body out with air to block themselves in. And these legs are pretty strong as well. He had a good grip in there. See, he's salivating on me. Now monitors, it's recently been discovered, actually possess venom glands. And so much bacteria on their venom that I can kill small mammals, sometimes even large ones. Now this guy's got a little growth on his hand here. Don't know what that's from. Monitor lizards have amazing antibodies, so a growth like that wouldn't bother him at all. Look at the ticks all over him. All these parasites. Now when they shed their skin, as you can see he's doing right now, a lot of the times they'll shed those ticks off. But I'll help him out and pull a few of them off. They also scratch up against the rocks to scrape all those ticks off. Look at the talons on him. Alright, man. Look at those claws. They can do a lot of damage if they scratch it into you, trust me. It's happened to me a few times. Oh, he's pulling on me. There we go. Oh, that was lucky. Good timing. You little devil. Oh, that smells. See his back? See the shattered skin? This tail is solid muscle. And a defense mechanism with monitor lizards are they'll flick this tail and whip their, whip whatever's trying to predate them or harass them. So like me. Those teeth are sharp, deceptively sharp, and they point backwards as well. So once he's got a hold of something, he ain't letting it go. This guy will be eating other lizards, even snakes. They'll even eat birds too. He's actually calmed down a lot. When he was in the rock, he was putting up a real tough fight, so I think we're both a bit tired. Look at him. Be about a meter long. They do get a little bit bigger than this, but he'll be classified as a fairly decent sized one. Not much spectacular colors, but perfect for camouflaging amongst these rocks. Oh, beautiful.
As more days pass in this forest, I've found no more signs of lions. Whatever I'm doing isn't working, and I'm starting to lose hope.
We'll get one.
I've seen other large animals, like the golden jackal, the nilgai, and the majestic black buck. But the rare Asiatic lion is proving to be just that. After more days of searching, it becomes clear. If I have any chance of finding these lions, I need to change my tactics. This will be my last day searching this forest on foot. Tracking lions from a vehicle will allow me to travel further into the area and cover much more ground. By the looks of it, there is plenty of water around, which means the lions have probably dispersed deeper into the forest. So that's exactly where I need to be.
We've seen lots of chital, samba deer, and cattle, which are all major food sources for the Asiatic lion. So there's plenty of food here. Hopefully we find some lions shortly. The main difference between the African lion and the Asiatic lion is size and a flap of skin that runs down the belly of the Asiatic lion. Now, size-wise, African lions get to about males, 250 kilos in some cases. In Asian lions, up to 200, from 150 to 200. So they're still big animals. Now, in the males, the mane is a bit smaller and spreads down from the chest a little bit more than in the African lion. Other than that, they're big predators and they're just as dangerous.
The further we journey into this forest, the more abundant with wildlife it becomes. I start to see species I never saw when I was walking through this habitat. The further away from people we get, the more life is flourishing.
There is over 320 species of bird found in this park alone. So it's a birder's dream. And we've already seen a few. We've seen sandpipers, seen kingfishers, sacred ibis, lots of bird of prey flying around, hornbills as well, one of my favorites. So this park isn't just home to the largest population of leopards in India or ungulates in India, but also a massive population and variety of different bird species. It's a pretty cool feeling driving through this forest because in one area, it looks just like the African savanna, like the Serengeti, lowland grass areas and real flat grassy plains. Then in other areas, like this now, it's almost like jungle, like thick jungle you would see in Southeast Asia. It's really a melting pot of different habitats and environments right here in this forest.
As the day passes, I'm yet to find any lion tracks. My frustration builds as I realize another day has gone by without any sign of these big cats. Maybe I was wrong to end my search on foot. Being in a vehicle may be causing me to miss any lion tracks on the ground. The next morning, I'm starting the search even earlier. Lions are most active in the early morning and in the evening, and I've already found some promising fresh tracks. This is a good sign. It means there were lions here last night, and it could mean they are still in the area.
Stop. Alrighty.
The tracks lead into even deeper forest, and I can even see imprints of where the lions have been laying. The pug marks are only faint, but it may be enough for me to track to their location. We're searching the area where the paw prints were found, and I'm starting to see more on the side of the road. The tracks lead past the Kamaleshwar Dam, the largest body of water in this forest. After driving a short distance, I get my next glimmer of hope, the sound of chital deer in distress.
It's pretty eerie. Silence. And all you can hear is the chital alarm call. But everything is dead still. And it's quite creepy knowing that there is a big predator in this area. The chital are very, very upset with something. Gonna go check it out.
Less than 100 meters up the road, I found out why the chital were freaking out.
Finally, after a full day of tracking and driving through this forest, there is our reward, the Asiatic lion. There are about 1,600 critically endangered giant pandas on the planet. Now there are only 400 of these lions on this planet, and you can only find them here in Gujarat. I'm less than 10 meters away from one of the rarest and most endangered large carnivores on our planet. And it's a female, it's a lioness, and she's big. It's an absolute privilege to be so close to such an amazing and majestic creature. Man, I'm stoked.
Just as I'm thinking this day can't get any better, I'm gifted with another surprise.
Oh my lord, look at her. Oh, she looks straight at my face.
My quest in the Gir Forest is complete. I studied its biodiversity and I found lions. I saw an abundance of wildlife during my time here, which means the lions can't be leaving this forest because of a lack of food. For the next half of my mission, I need to find lions outside of this forest. I need to see for myself just how far away these cats are roaming. During my time in Sasangir, I've made contacts through some of the locals. These people have told me they may know where to find these stray lions. It seems getting in contact with these people is nearly as hard as getting in contact with the lions.
That's an answering machine, actually.
Not one of my contacts have answered their phones or replied to my messages.
It did this before, but it actually had a ringtone.
Just as I decide to call it a day, I'm approached by a family who have some good information.
It's on a farm, yeah. Right now.
Yes, maybe. They killed a buffalo.
Killed buffalo.
It killed a buffalo.
Yeah. So they will come at night.
Okay.
It's final.
Right. Is there any chance somebody could show us or take us or?
Yeah. He can, means he can show you.
Yeah. Normal pani in the water. You can show us.
Yes. Can dekha dekho. Oh, tar ban kar diya
hoga. Batai hoga na.
Haan.
Kya na?
Na, he will show.
He will show us when.
Kila hai ki? Come to it.
After 9 o'clock.
After 9 o'clock.
Okay. You can come to it with us.
Okay.
See, this is Indian food.
Oh yeah.
You want to eat it?
It's a pakoda.
Oh, is it?
It's a pakoda. Yeah, eat it. Home program. So you're coming there?
They want us to have dinner with them, and then they'll take us to a farm where a lion apparently is. So maybe they're fattening me up for the lions. Yeah.
So they have agreed to show me the lion on the condition that I have dinner with their family, and I'm not one to turn down a hot meal.
Okay, that's all right. No, not far, not far. All right, no worries. We'll see you tonight. See you later on.
I was under the impression that their family dinner would consist of 4 or maybe 5 people. But when I arrived, it seems the whole town had been invited.
Hello.
I was definitely a little caught off guard. I wasn't expecting such a large turnout. It felt like I was in a Gujarati version of The Bachelor. It was interesting to see how all the food was prepared. Gujarat is a completely vegetarian state, so there was no shrimp to be tossed onto this barbie. The aroma from all the vegetables and spices was overwhelming, and I can't wait to get stuck into some of that local cuisine. But first, they insisted on giving me a tour of the house.
Hand painted, nice. Yeah, it's beautiful.
See there.
Oh, man on horse. My favourite.
They wanted me to prove my animal catching skills, and a common house gecko seemed like a pretty easy target. I figure if this family is going to feed me and potentially help me find a lion, I may as well offer them a bit of entertainment. I'm not sure which one they wanted the photo of more, me or the gecko. I'm thinking the latter. After all the gecko excitement, now I feast.
Looks good.
People are coming at me from all directions and literally hand feeding me food. But I'm not complaining.
Oh, I love it. Ooh, that was nice. It's like a samosa. Another one.
Nobody told me I couldn't go back for seconds or even thirds.
I'll grab a couple more of these.
At this point, they probably regret inviting me. I don't think they realise how much I actually eat.
I got some onions, some sauce, some minty yogurt sort of stuff, those deep fried dumplings and some other deep fried thing, but it looks good.
You can sit there.
Let's over there? Alrighty.
After a good feed, it's finally time to try find this lion. We're driving through busy towns, main roads, and through farmland. Probably the last place you'd expect to find a lion. After nearly an hour's drive, it's clear we're getting into more rural land, and we are now a good distance away from the Gir Forest.
So we're about 40 kilometres away from the protected area of Gir Forest. We've just caught word from one of the locals that a lion has been spotted on a nearby farm in one of the villages. So we're heading there now to see if we can catch a glimpse of an Asiatic lion.
After another 20 minutes in the car, we've reached our destination. We are now about 60 kilometers away from the Gir Forest.
So we've just got out of the car. We're literally in the middle of a village, someone's farm, looking for these cats. So we're going this way now. The only thing we have for protection is a stick.
These four blokes have seen lions on people's properties before, And it seems buffalo snatching is a fairly common occurrence for these wandering lions.
Seven lions.
Seven lions were there for one buffalo, two buffaloes. Seven lions.
Buffalo wouldn't have lasted long. So all these lions were found outside.
Yes.
The park.
Yeah. Outside the park.
Outside the park. Wow.
It is pitch black, and we can only see whatever the torchlight hits. There is definitely a feeling of vulnerability walking around in pitch darkness with a lion in close proximity.
We're walking around for about half an hour now, looking for pud marks in the sand, and looking for this carcass as well. So apparently the lion still is in the area, it's just a matter of finding it in the long grass.
I spot a flicker of something tawny coloured in the long grass. Then, our torchlight illuminates something very special.
I'm about 20 metres away from a female Asiatic lion in the middle of somebody's farm, eating a buffalo that she's caught. That buffalo belongs to one of these people that own this farm. She doesn't even seem to mind that we're here. And she is big. What a stunning animal.
After observing this lion for a little bit longer, I think I can make out a small mane, and I'm fairly sure it's actually a young male. Determining that this lion is actually a male may have just confirmed my theory as to why they are leaving their natural habitat. This isn't happening because of a lack of food or water in the forest. This is purely a territory issue. This male lion is at the age where he is starting to roam and look for his own females and territory. It seems the Gujarat forest may not be big enough for these cats.
Oh, he's up. Yep, definitely a male. Yes. Not a female at all, it is a male, a young male. Oh, wow.
My mission in the beautiful Sasangir is complete. The Indian jungle was a setting for Rudyard Kipling's The Jungle Book, and I can definitely see why. After spending 2.5 weeks here, and seeing the large amount of biodiversity and prey species for these lions, I've come to the conclusion that there is no shortage of prey in this forest. In fact, it has the largest population of ungulates in any protected forest in India. So the food sources are here, but the territory isn't. That's why these lions are in fact moving outside of this protected forest and closer to people. After being so close to these animals and seeing them in the flesh, they certainly are the kings of this jungle. And they are, in fact, the last kings of India.